Video by CBS News. New York, New York City's deadliest residential fire in decades apparently began as a child played with a first-floor stove, then spread quickly throughout a Bronx apartment building, killing 12 people and leaving 4 others fighting for their lives. Mayor Bill de Blasio said Friday. Those who died Thursday night included girls ages 1, 2 and 7, and a boy whose age was not given. De Blasio, a Democrat, says responders saved at least 12 lives. Fire Commissioner Daniel Nigro called the fire historic in its magnitude because of the number of lives lost, excluding the Sept. 11 attacks. It was the worst fire in the city since 87 people were killed at a social club fire in the Bronx in 1990. Our hearts go out to every person who lost a loved one here and everyone who is fighting for their lives, Nigro said. The blaze broke out on the first floor of a five-story building just before 7 p.m. and quickly tore through the roughly century-old structure near the Bronx Zoo. Some tenants of the building, a mix of native New Yorkers and Latino and African immigrants, climbed down fire escapes, but the flames moved so fast that many never made it out of their apartments. The cause of the fire remained under investigation. About 170 firefighters worked in bone-chilling cold, just 15 degrees, to rescue about a dozen people from the building. Thierno Diallo, 59, a security guard originally from Conakry, Guinea, who lives in a ground-floor apartment, said he was asleep when he heard banging on the door. It took him a moment to realize what was happening. New York fire slideshow by photo services. Only when I heard people screaming, "There's a fire in the building," he said, "I heard somebody, oh, fire, fire, fire." He ran outside in his bathrobe, jacket and sandals. Kenneth Kodua, 37, said he left his apartment to get food, leaving his roommate behind, and came back to find people fleeing in a panic. Hours later, he was still trying to find out whether his roommate had escaped. "I tried calling her. I tried calling. No answer," he said, still clutching his bag of uneaten food. His phone was dead. Many questions remained in the immediate aftermath of the blaze, including how the fire spread so quickly in a brick building built after catastrophic fires at the turn of the 20th century ushered in an era of tougher enforcement of fire codes. The building had more than 20 units. It was not new enough that it was required to have modern-day fireproofing, like sprinkler systems and interior steel construction. Witnesses described seeing burned bodies being carried away on stretchers and young girls who had escaped standing barefoot outside with no coats. Twambredu, 61, arrived in the neighborhood looking for his brother, who had been staying with a family in the building. The family, a husband and wife and 4 children, got out, but there was no word about his brother. "I've been calling his phone. It's ringing, but nobody picks up," Bredu said. "He was in his room, and we don't know what happened." The death toll surpassed the 10 who died, including 9 children, in a 4-story home in another part of the Bronx in 2007. That blaze had been sparked by a space heater. Firefighters respond to a building fire Thursday, Deck 28, 2017, in the Bronx borough of New York. The Fire Department of New York says a blaze raging in the Bronx apartment building has seriously injured more than a dozen of people. AP photo, Frank Franklin II.